Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a retro colorful text effect with glittering stars against colorful starbursts of light. This document is 1280 by 720 pixels with a resolution of 72 pixels per inch. Let's fill our document with black. There are many ways to do this. If you already have black as your foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill the layer with black. If your foreground color isn't black, press the letter D first. Another way is to press Shift plus F5 to call up the Fill window and choose Black and click OK. We'll make a copy of the background. Press Control or Command plus J. Call up your gradient tool and make sure the linear gradient is highlighted. Press Shift and click on the bottom of your document, drag up, and release. This created a linear gradient with black on the bottom and white at the top. Go to Filter, Distort, and Wave. The Wave window will open. The number of generators is 10. The wavelength is 10 to 120. The amplitude is 5 to 35. The scale is 100%. The type is square. And repeat edge pixels. Go to Filter, Distort, and Polar Coordinates. Choose Rectangular to Polar. Go back to Filter, Render, and Lighting Effects. Choose Omni for the light type, 20 for intensity, the gloss is shiny, and the material plastic. This gives our starburst a softer feel. Click on the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Call up your gradient tool again and click on the arrow next to the gradient box. Click on the inside arrow to open your list of gradient presets. I'm choosing a preset called Noise Samples. Click Append. This adds the noise sample presets to your current presets in the gradient window. I'll click on this preset, which is called Blues. Click on the thumbnail box and this will call up the gradient editor. Uncheck Restrict Colors and click OK. Go to the center of the starburst, press Shift, and drag a line to the right edge of your document. Release, and change the blend mode to color. Let's blur the colors a little bit. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it between 7 to 8 pixels. We created a great effect of a colorful starburst of light with cool-looking halos. We're ready to add some text to it. Let's hide the top two layers by clicking off their eyeballs and leave the background visible. Call up your type tool and click on your character text box. I'm choosing a font called DecoTech, which you can download for free at defont.com. Click on the paragraph tab and choose center text. Click back on the character tab and click on the color box. Choose white and click on your document and type out your text. To reposition it, call up your Move tool, click on your text and move it. In the Layers panel, slide the fill to 0. Click on the FX icon and choose Inner Glow. The blend mode is green, the opacity is 75%, the technique softer and the source edge, and the size is 5 pixels. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is Inner Bevel. The technique Smooth. The depth is 300%. The size is 2 pixels. And the gloss contour is Cone Inverted. Check Contour and click OK. We're going to duplicate the text. To do this, press Control or Command plus J. Double-click on Inner Glow to call it up in the Layer Style window and change the size to 10 pixels. Uncheck Bevel and Emboss and Contour, and check Outer Glow. Change the size to 5 pixels and click OK. Click on the little arrows on the right of the text layers to collapse the list of effects. You're not deleting them, you're just giving yourself more room. Let's add some twinkles to our text. Make a new layer, and we'll rename it Twinkles. Call up your brush tool, and click on this little arrow. Click on the inside arrow to call up the list of your brush presets. You probably don't have the Twinkle Brush preset we'll be using, so I included the download link in the video's description. If you don't know how to install brushes or other presets, I have a tutorial that will show you how. I provided the link for that tutorial in the video's description too. Once you install the Twinkle Brush preset, scroll down and click it. When this window opens, click OK so we can just see this set in the thumbnail window. Click on one of the twinkles. I'll click on this one. To reduce its size, click on the left bracket key. Now click on some of the edges of your text until you have enough. Let's make the twinkles more expansive. To do this, we need to make two copies of the twinkles. Press Ctrl or Command plus J twice. We'll rename the top copy Horizontal Blur and the bottom copy Vertical Blur. Go to Filter, Blur, and Motion Blur. Since the Vertical Blur twinkle is active, we'll make the angle 90 degrees and the distance 150 pixels. Click on the Horizontal Blur twinkle to make it active. Go to Filter, Blur, and Motion Blur. Make the angle 0 degrees and keep the distance the same. Let's merge all three twinkle layers together by pressing Ctrl or Command E twice. Click the eyeball back on the color layer to make it visible and drag it to the top. Now, all visible layers below it will contain its colors because its blend mode is color. Go to the Starburst layer and click it to make it visible. We can dramatically alter the image by simply changing the color of the background. Call up your gradient tool and choose another gradient. I'll click down on the lower left and drag up a line to the upper right and release. Let's do one more. Click another gradient. I'll click on the upper left and drag this one to the lower right. Have fun experimenting with various combinations to instantly create colorful, dramatic effects. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.